Hi, in this video, I'm gonna show you different types and styles of hand lettering. Something that people ask me a lot is what are the different types of letters they can create in order to create big pieces of lettering? And I think that's very interesting because every big lettering piece starts with a single letter. So if you can manage to do a letter very well, you can build everything from the beginning into a big piece in the end. And I usually talk about four different basic types of lettering, and I'm gonna show you them now one by one so you can start practicing your own. The first one and the most basic of all, in my opinion, is the sans serif type. That is also being called around like block letters. I do call them block letters. And this type of letters, the sans serif, they are called block letters because they are just that, letters in blocks. And it's the most basic because it's very similar to what we are used to write in capital letters and see in capital letters. Like this is an A, and you can write a B or a C. And they are called block letters in lettering because you can create them in blocks so they have more of a personality to them. These letters like this, I usually call them the skeleton because it's just the basic form of the letter, and I can create some like this for an A, for example, and when I fill that in with ink, I basically have the block letter, you know? So this is an A, sans serif A. And hopefully that will focus. Yeah, like that. So this is an A, and I can do basically every other letter like that, creating blocks. So my B can be something like that. More or less. I don't have guides here, so it's gonna be a little bit messy, but you get the idea, right? So these are the sans serif. You can think about them like the basic alphabet that you use to see around or type or just the basic form, also called the block letters. And the second type of letters that we can used to start lettering are the serif letters. So the serif letters, we can compare them directly to the sans serif because they're basically the same thing, only the serif letters, they have like little decorative strokes in the end of the letter form. For example, if I have an A just like I did in the last type of letter, I can put a serif here and here, so you can see the this little decorative elements that are called the serifs. So they have serifs. Or on a B, if I draw the B normally as I would, I can put these little serifs in here, and it becomes a serif alphabet. One letter that you can see serifs very well is the letter E. So I can put an E here. I have a serif here, one here, one here, and those two ends in here. So those are serif letters. They have those decorative elements there. And you can also draw them in blocks. And most of the time, you're gonna see serif letters with different stroke weights. Like I'm drawing here, you can see that this side is very thin and this side is very thick. I have my crossbar here. Okay, so this is a a basic, very basic serif letter. I'm not gonna put too much into that. You get the idea. They have these little decorative elements, and usually they have this different in the stroke width. So you see thick here and thin right here. Okay, the third type of letter that I absolutely love, it's one of my favorites, is the cursive letter. And the cursive letter is the letter in the way we write usually. For example, here I have an A, and this is my B, can have a C and D, and they kind of flow when you're writing. They're the cursive type, the type we learn in school and stuff like that, you know? And when we come to a cursive alphabet, you can also talk about the brush alphabet. Like if you use a brush, and I have one right here, you can put some width difference in them, and you can see that I have some parts that are really thick and some parts that are really thin. Also in the B and the C. So I have those type of cursive. You can see that on my upstrokes I have thin, and on the downstroke I have thick. That's how the brush alphabet works. But the base of this is the cursive alphabet. And again, this you can think about them as the skeleton. And you can even fake it if you don't have a brush pen. I can write an A and put fake weights on it and fill them. So it's very similar with what I had on the top here. So you can also fake the cursive type of letter. And the last type that I want to show you in this video to complete these basic types that I think you should know is the decorative, or like I like to call them, are the creative. I call them the creative type of letter, but you're gonna see more people talking about them like the decorative type or something like that. And it's basically a letter that you draw, like you essentially draw them. You turn them into a really, really, really drawn something. Like for example, I can create an A right here and absolutely decorate it to the end, put some lines and various elements, and really play with the letter without worrying about anything besides the shape of the letter. If I can recognize that as a letter, I can decorate it as much as I want. For example, I also like to draw O's, and let's pretend this O is a donut. So here I have a decorative letter, creative letter, that is basically something else. I just put a letter into a drawing, or draw something as if it was a letter. And I also have here some examples that I can show you. Let me just get my notebook that I've trying some different types of letters. So you can see here I have a serif with some curved serifs. I have a type of cursive here in cap. And some decoratives, a lot of decoratives actually. I have this that seems like a ribbon. This one's like a cake or a little ice cream or something. This one seems like a paper plane. So a monster. This one, I just put some decorative elements like a machine or something. So you can see that you can really play and draw the letters. So I have a lot of creative letters here and some sans serif and serif. This is actually a serif type. This is a serif type too. I have some cursives around and some sans serif with some decorative elements. And you can really play with the letters. So those are the four types of letters that I would recommend you practice. And you can even create a notebook like that and fill that with letters so you can practice and get more used to drawing them. I also always say that you should start small. So start with one letter at a time and try that in different ways. Try all these types with the letter A, then the letter B, then the letter C. And when you feel confident, you can start jumping to words and even phrases. Just start small so you can see how you progress into that. That's all I have for you today. I hope you like it. If you like it, like the video, share with your friends, and leave a comment. Thank you very much for your attention. Bye bye.